The year was 1987, back when Hawkey was still married to Hazel. John Howard's policy on eyebrow trimming was still strict.
I think our basic policy direction is correct, yes.
A young Kerry O'Brien looked like Mum dressed him up for the first day of school.
The greater the chance that he'll remain leader.
And back when political ad campaigns featured Australians who sounded like this.
Mr. Howard, me and my family would like to ask you some real simple questions.
It was the last time a double dissolution election was called. And it worked.
Tonight, the Hawke Labor government returned to power.
Bob Hawke won the top job for the third time.
Hawke, although it caused the double dissolution on the basis of the Australia Card Bill, didn't really campaign on that issue. It just became a normal general election campaign. There's only been six double dissolutions and they haven't played out as successfully as that one.
Section 57 of the Australian Constitution allows the government to call an early dissolution of both the House of Reps and the whole of the Senate, resulting in a federal election. If the Senate blocks the government's attempts to pass legislation twice, with a gap of 3 months in between each attempt, the Prime Minister can trigger a double dissolution. It's a mechanism to break deadlocks between the lower house and the Senate when the government doesn't control a majority of both houses. The Coalition plans to bring forward two pieces of legislation aimed at curbing the power of unions in the next few months, which, if defeated by the Senate, could provide a trigger for a double dissolution election.
There's always a lot of hyperventilating, if I may say so, from the media about will there or won't there be an election anytime soon.
I wouldn't rule out the fact that he might go to an early election, because if you look at the budgetary situation as it was brought down a few months ago, you would perhaps want to bring down another one.
Calling a double dissolution is risky. The government would only want to try and do it if they knew they could win, and win convincingly, i.e. with many friends in the Senate.
The mechanism is there so that if you have a signature piece of legislation that this government really stands for, but that the Senate is blocking, that they can force that issue and secure that. Take it to the people, say this is something that we really believe in, that we told you before we really believe in, and they're stopping us. I think trying to use it in other contexts is fraught with difficulty, because although it might give the current government a larger majority in the House of Representatives, I think it's likely to leave them with a much more difficult Senate.